channel. And I want to say thank you for all your support so far. Thank you for the comments. Thank you for the likes. Your feedback really means a lot to me. And I'm saying a big thank you to you. So today I've come with another sewing tutorial or cutting tutorial. We're going to be cutting this shirt. And in case you're meeting me for the first time, my name is Folake Adedeji. I'm the creative director at AC Mon Fashion Academy and I run this channel. So in case you have not yet subscribed, please subscribe because you're going to be gaining a lot from this channel. I'm going to be teaching you so many sewing tips and tricks. I'm going to be showing you a lot of trendy styles, how to cut and sometimes even how to sew them. And you will rock it beautifully and even make for others. So in case you are yet to subscribe, click on the subscription button, turn on notifications so that anytime I upload a new video, you will be notified. So let's get started. So I'll start by putting the measurement I'll be working with. I will need my hip measurements. I'm working with hip measurements. I'll be using 41.5. I'll work with my tine. I'll be working with 25 inches. I'll be working with crotch, of course. That's 10.5, and that's how to measure it. It's showing on the screen. Also, now I'll go this way. So from the start line, I'm going to insert my hip line measurements. I'll be working with 8 as my hip line measurement. Working with 8, I'm going to rule the line. Working with 8, I'll rule it all through so I can get a straight line. So I'm going to also mark my crotch line. Sit at the start line and mark my crotch line. So I'm working with 10.5. Working with 10.5. So I'm going to connect the lines. Let's connect the lines. So our label, so here's my hip line, here's my hip line, and here is my crotch line, here's my crotch line. So the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to insert my hip measurement. So I'm working with 41.5, I'm working with 41.5, so I'm going to divide 41.5 into 4 places. Dividing 41.5 into 4 places, I have 10.25. So I'll just add quarter as is. So that means that I have 10.5. So I'll just mark 10.5. I'll start from the crotch line. I'll mark 10.5 on the crotch line. I'll come to the hip line. I'll mark 10.5. I'll come to the waist line and I'll mark 10.5. So this start line can also, it's also my waist line. So I'm labeling also. So I'm going to connect these points with my ruler. Connect like so. So I've connected. So the next thing I'm going to do is to insert my crotch width. So I'm going to insert, this is the crotch line, this is the crotch length. So now I'm going to insert my crotch width so that I can draw my curve. Are you following? So I'm going to get my crotch line in either two ways. I can decide to use my tine measurement divided by 2. I can say tine, I'm using 25 divided by 2, that's 12.5. I can then subtract it from my hip measurement. Hip measurement is 41.5. 41.5 into 4 places, I have 10.25. So I can either do it this way, or I can divide this line. So if I do this, then I have like 2.25 or thereabouts. I have 2.25 or thereabouts. But I can also decide to take this line that's from this point to this point. That's this point to this point. That's my hip measurement divided by 4. I can divide it into 4. Probably this would be easier to divide. So I can just divide this into 4. And then once I divide into 4, I will take a part. I'll just take a part that's like a quarter and use for my crotch length, for my crotch width. Do we understand? So this is half. This is 10 and half. This is half of it, right? I'll divide it into half. Now I want to get the quarter of it. So here is a quarter. So I'm going to put this quarter as my crotch width. Can you see? So that's how to get our crotch width. Either you do it this way, the time divided by 2, you know, minus the hip divided by 4. So the difference is going to be the width of the crotch, right? Or you divide this line, that's this hip divided by 4, and you know we added ease of 0.25. So either you divide this line into 4, and then you take a part of it, and then use as your crotch width. So I'm sure we get that. So now we're going to connect this line and draw a smooth curve. So I'm going to place my taper at this point. I'll place my taper this way and I'll take 1 inch. So I've taken 1 inch. So I've taken 1 inch. So I'm going to connect this point, this point, this point, and this point. So I'll draw my curve. You can use your French curve to do that as well. And just use your French curve to connect. You just make sure you're connecting from here. Here we have 2 and a half. Depending on your hip line to your crotch line, you can do 3. You know, and then you connect, you come in, you come to this corner, take 1 inch, you know, and then you connect. Connect the lines, the points, and then you form your crotch. So that's it. So the next thing we're going to do, we're going to, you know, mark our time measurement. So the time is usually about 2 and a half, 3 inches below the crotch line. This is our crotch line. So I'll just come 3 inches. I'll be using 3 inches. 3 inches is an average. So I'll just use 3 inches. I want to get a straight line, so that's why I'm doing this 3 inches. So I'll connect the lines. So the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to find the midpoint between from this point and this point. I'm going to find the midpoint. So I'm going to place my taper this way. It's 13 and 2. And then I'm going to come like this. So here's the midpoint, 6. So I'll just place it here. And mark. I'll place it here as well and mark. I'm using this to guide me. So I'll place it here also and I'll mark. So this is the midpoint. I just want to get my the midpoint. So I'm going to connect. I'm going to connect. Remember, I told us that we are putting band. We are using rubber at the top part. So we are not going to shape the waist because we are using rubber. So we won't be shaping the waist. So now that I've done this, I'm going to insert my time measurement. So I'm working with time 25, remember? Working with time 25. 25 divided by 2, I have 12 and a half. I'll just extend this line before I do that. Extend it. So 12 and a half. Okay, wait. 12 and a half. So this is 12 and a half. Yes, 12 and a half. That's my 25 divided by 2. So I come this way. So I'm going to put this at the middle. So I'll put this at the middle. And then I'll mark. So I'll mark. And I'll come here and mark 12.5 as well. Let's see, so I've marked 12.5. So these are my marks. So the next thing I'm going to, you know, find the length of my shorts. I'm working with length 20. I'm working with length 20. So I'll put my tuple at the waistline. And I'll come here. This is 20. I mark 20. Because I want to get a straight line, I'll just mark it in two places. I put it here as well and I mark 20. So I'm going to connect the line. Can you see? So the next thing, I'm going to put my measurement also. That's the bottom, the circumference of the bottom of my shorts. So I'm working with 19. So the circumference, I'm working with 19, that's the bottom. I'm working with 19, I've written 19. So I'll pick my tuple as well. This is 19, this is 19. I'll divide into two, folding it this way. 19 divided by 2, 9.5. So 9.5 divided into 2 again, this is 9.5 into 2. I have 4 and 7, so I'm going to place it at the center this way. This at the center this way. I'll mark it to the on both sides, and then I'll come this way and I'll mark the 9.5 as well. Now you see, so these are the lines. These are the points for the, that's the bottom of my shirt. And then on the, my tie line, this is the tie line. I'll just mark or label. And here's the bottom. Here's the bottom. And so, or the M, that the bottom or the M. So this is the mark on the tie line. So I'm going to connect this point from the crotch line. I'll connect it to the tie line and then to the bottom. I'll do the same thing here too from this crotch. That's, I'll connect it to it and this. So like so. Stretch. Just watch as I'm connecting it this way and this way. So I'll come here as well and I'll connect it. So like I said, we are not shaping the waist because we are going to be putting our rubber, and so we are not going to shape it. So we need a lot of allowance so that it can be easy to wear. I hope you understand. So now I'm going to use the front to cut the back. I'm going to use the front to cut the back. So I'll just cut this out now. I'm not putting that because it's not a fitted shirt. So I'll just cut it out, just watch. Okay, so I've placed, this is the front pattern, and I've placed on another pattern, that's the fresh paper. So I'll just hold it down, because I'll be using the front, like I said, to cut the back. I'll just hold it down with my tip so it doesn't move while I'm, you know, drafting on it. So I'll just place it this way, ensuring I have enough, you know, space at the sides, upper parts, and, you know, let me just move it down a little. Let's move it down a little. So, this way. I'll also leave it at this edge. So now my paper is stable. So the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to be extending the crotch line. I'm going to be extending the crotch line. Extending it. So let me extend the waistline as well. It's the waistline. Extending it as well. So I've done that. So I'm going to also mark 2 inches on the crotch line. This way, so that's my 2 inches line. So after that, the next thing I'm going to do is to, you know, raise my this crotch line. I'm going to extend it as well, but I need a guide. So, you know, I used 2 inches here, right? I'm going to come here also and come in by 2 inches. This is my waistline. Can you see the front pattern? I just want to use it as a guide on the length of my crotch. So I'm going to come here by 2 inches. Can you see? So, you know, for the width of my crotch, I used 2.5 for the width. Remember when we're drafting, I can still confirm with your tip. So you can see I have 2.5 here. So on this point, these 2 inches I marked, I'm going to come place it this way. Place my tip this way. I marked the 2.5 inch. Can you see? So now I have the 2 inches. I'm going to come here as well and mark the same 2.5. I'm going to, from this point, I'm going to mark the same 2.5 this way. You know, this is just to shape on the back, because even though I'm using rubber, I don't want so much bulge at the back. And then also so that when you sit wearing it, it doesn't open up, you know. It's firmer to your waist if I do it this way. You understand? Ordinarily, would have just connected a straight line since we are putting rubber, you know, and all of that, but I want this shape at the back as well. I want it to rest firmly when we are wearing it and we are sitting down. So that's why I'm going through all this process. So now we're going to connect these lines. Now, you know, we now have 3 points. We have the first point here when we extended by 2 inches. We have this point here, you know, that we got from this point to here. We used 2.5, and this 2.5 we got it from the width of our crotch line. So that means it will vary. You know, remember how we calculated it when we were drafting the front. Also, the same, to get the 2.5 here, we need a guide coming in by 2 inches as well. The same 2 inches we used here, we also came here by 2 inches, and then use this as a guide to get our 2.5 mark. So now we're going to connect this here to this, and you can use your curve ruler as well. So this time, I'll just use this. I just use this. I don't want this stopping me. I'll just connect. Just watch. You know, it's a really long curve. Just connect this way. I'll come here as well. I'm not making use of this. This is just to guide us. We are not using that. Then I come here and I also connect. So I hope you can see. So these are crotch lines for the back. So we connected this point. This point, so the 3 points, we join them together. So that's it. So the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to confirm what I have on my waist, you know, for the front. This is what I have. I have 10.5. Can you see? So I'm going to bring the 10.5 here. I'm going to bring the 10.5 here, and I'll slant it till I get to my waist. I don't know if you understand what I mean. 10.5, this is 10.5 here. So I'm going to slant it and make sure it lands on the waistline. Now this is the waistline that I extended the waistline as well. Remember, I extended it as well. So I want to make sure I get my 10.5, and then that it is on the waistline. So I'm going to do it this way. Can you see? So I have my 10.5. So I'm going to mark So this is my 10.5 mark. So I'm going to connect this point. I'm going to connect it to this. So that will be my waistline for the back. I hope we are getting it. So this will be my waistline for the back. So that's my waistline. So the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to check what I have here. I have 1.5 here, you know. So on the hip line, I'll add 1 inch. Add 1 inch. On the crotch line, I'll add 1 inch. On the tie line, I'll add 1 inch. At the bottom of the shorts, I will add 1 inch. So that's it. So I'm going to connect. I'll still use my ruler. I decided to use this. This has a little curve. Just use the straight part for this side. Just a bit too. I'll use the straight part for this side as well. So that's for the back shaping. Can you see? So that's just because of the band I'll be using here. So we have done that, and then the next thing we are going to do is to finish up this edge. So at this edge, I'll equally add 1 inch. I'll also add 1 inch. That's from this tie line. I'll add 1 inch. I'll come here to the bottom, I'll add 1 inch. So I'm going to connect. I'm going to just connect the points. You see the points here, here, and here. So I'll connect the 2 points. So that's it. So let me see. I'll just finish up this bottom part, the end part. So that's it. So I think we are done. We're not putting that, like I said, it's a free top. So I'm going to cut it out now. So I'll cut it out. Watch. So I've come to the end of today's tutorial. If you like it and you have gained something, please click on the like button. Also, if you are yet to subscribe, kindly click on the subscription button, turn on notification so that anytime I upload a new video, you will be notified. So in case you want to see the sewing part of this pattern, please drop your comment down below. Remember that we have not subtracted our band from the paper, so when you're cutting on your fabric, remember to, you know, take out 2 inches for the band. So I can see from the picture, the band is about 2 inches. So you're going to cut out 2 inches from your pattern, and then on your fabric you'll be cutting 2.5 inches. The 0.5 inches extra is to join it to this. And also remember to put your sewing allowance while you're cutting. But if you want to see the sewing tutorial, please drop your comment down below. I'll be glad to hear from you. So I'll see you in my next video. Bye for now.